Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Today we're doing a video on Restylane Refyne and Defyne. I've been traveling around the country now and a lot of people are starting to use the product because it's very unique. It's flexible. It really expands. And we have Refyne, which is a softer, finer product for fine lines, and Defyne, which is robust and strong, great for the marionette or the oral commissure. Now, a lot of people I'm finding are a little hesitant to use the product because of the injection technique, and they think it's such a different product, which it is, and that they must have to inject it much differently. But the reality is, you can continue and actually start with your regular technique for this area, and then continue to develop some new little tricks and pearls for the product. I'm gonna show you today something that's been very popular. It's very successful with the patients in providing lift, and it's a great way to use the product, which is a microdroplet technique, meaning small boluses along the commissure, along the jawline. You can use it in the edge of the lip and through the all-important modiolus, which is a technique we used to use years ago, and it works so well with this product. I rarely used that technique before. This product lends itself to that technique. And remember, Refyne and Defyne were present in other countries in Europe, and over 1.6 million syringes have been injected before coming to the United States. So it's very safe, very effective. Let's go to the video. I'll show you that technique. And remember, it doesn't draw water in, so it's my go-to for the lower face, but wherever you want a robust filler that's flexible, very natural, moves with the body, you can use this hyaluronic acid filler. So I'm gonna start with the droplet technique here. There's two ways to do it. We can do linear threading. I'm gonna tilt you a little that way. I usually start at the bottom of the fold. I'll do the linear threading technique. We got Restylane Defyne here. Coming in, the bevel's not so important. I do an antegrade injection, creating a space. This is a 27 gauge needle. It flows very smoothly. And then injecting again. Now, a little irregularity here, that's gonna smooth out nicely. Next poke coming here, a little stick here, very good. And then we're gonna do a little antegrade and a little retrograde. We're gonna do Plasmasculpt on the patient as well today, but we're gonna add just a little bit in these nasolabial folds because they're a little dominant, and we did do our Plasmasculpt last time, but having a little HA in there is gonna be helpful. Now, I'm holding here with this finger because if we don't bruise patients, we keep them. So I can use this to support the patient. I know my landmark, even though I'm losing it when I move, I visually remembered it. So I'm injecting in, and I'm, again, antegrade. This is where your nasalis artery is. Remember, 50% of cadavers we look at are aberrant, but we have to consider that 50% the nasalis will be where we expect it. So it's not a sure deal that the artery's there, but it's likely, it could be anywhere. So we're always watching, knowing when we get up to the nasal alveoli, it's a little riskier. So I like to hold the pressure. We wanna use a good cadence for injection, not too quick. We take our time injecting, even though we aren't going in and out, or I see a lot of people just kind of feeling the skin and moving around, making themselves cerebrally feel good, but really not helping the patient. But where I take a lot of time is on a little bit of pressure, because if we don't bruise them, we keep them. Likewise with pain. Now we'll move to the other side. I'm gonna show you a droplet technique over there. So coming to the other side, now we're gonna cleanse. So I grab a new cleaner here. We're using a combination of cleaning products. I use two. So we're cleaning, and what I'm going to do, again, I'm holding pressure over here because that's where I injected, and that will help prevent a bruise. The droplet technique I often use in the lower face, which we will demonstrate at some point, but here I'm going to come in inferior. You're not deep here, and I'm just injecting on her 0.05. And I'm walking up towards the fold. Now, why would we use a droplet technique? Part of that is way back, I'm gonna say it was 2007, there was a study done on regular Restylane.
and we found that patients were doing better even way out from when their product should last. So even they'd come back 2 or 3 years later and they'd be improved. A little poke here. And a study was done here. I'll pull back because I'm in a more of a danger zone. A study was done, found type 2 and 3 collagen around the deposits, the boluses that were done in forearms or Restylane. So these boluses will help the product last long. They won't look irregular. I can see one area I want here. Again, I'm going to pull back a little. When you pull back, you're looking in the hub of the needle. You don't have to pull back too strong, but with an HA, a little more, of course, than you would for Sculptra. Now, I can come back and layer Sculptra on there in 4 to 8 weeks is what I do. And I hold a little bit of pressure, check my other side is not bleeding, so that's good. We had good pressure there. And I'm going to show you, I'm going to put a little at the edge of the mouth, just to show you that droplet technique down here. Here's the modiolus. There's a little bit of volume loss here. Little stick here, coming in. I'll pull back here, and I'm putting, again, 0.05, not a lot, but we know if we support that edge of the mouth, it gives a lift up. Little poke here. I'm going to put a little tiny bit at the edge of the mouth. And then supporting the modioles in an upward fashion. One more poke here. There's lidocaine in here. Okay. And that shows the edge of the mouth and the nasal fold with Restylane Defyne. So those are two ways you can do. You can do a linear threading, or you can do that droplet technique that works so well with this product. A lot of structure, a lot of support with Restylane Defyne. Refyne is for finer lines. Thanks for joining me today. Join me on YouTube, Instagram, and Facebook for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.